My name is Roger. I live in Wandsworth. I had my stroke in 2012.
What is the one thing you would like people to know about living with a stroke when they're communicating with you?
The old me is still inside. It's screaming out to you. Say, you don't have to treat me different. I only have speech, but I understand everything.
And Roger, has the way people treat you changed since you've had your stroke? Let's start with family.
Good family. Treat you like a kid. I have short-term memory loss. Like in cooking, if I not to use the oven, and that's the thing that you need to cook with. So I was left in a microwavable world of food for a long time.
They didn't trust you to use the oven?
No. By accident, my brother bought me some chicken, and he go not to waste it, and I got started cooking, and first your confidence is gone, but if you keep on, it gets much better.
And what about friends? Do friends treat you differently?
Some see that you are the same old Roger. Some don't.
And for ones that don't, what is it that they do differently?
Kill the fun. It's not fun to see a friend and relax. It's more kids' gloves. They don't treat you the same. Yeah.
And what about strangers? Do you think strangers, when they first meet you, recognise that you've had a stroke?
No. Strangers, they don't see that I've had a stroke. So a lot of things are different.
So for instance, if you're travelling on public transport, which you do, and you need to communicate with someone, maybe to ask them something or to just to find something out, is that a struggle?
Sometimes you just want to turn back around and go back the other way instead of asking someone for help.
Why is that?
They don't have time.
They have time?
Yeah.
And they wear the badge, don't they? That says happy to help or here to help.
You have to get their attention. And then you have to explain that you've had a stroke and you find it hard to communicate.
What's your name?
My name is Eunice.
And where do you live?
In
Greenwich, thank yes. you. And when did you have your stroke?
2016.
Eunice, what is the one thing you would like people to know about living with a stroke when they're communicating with you?
Listen. That's what.
That they have to listen.
Yes.
So, Eunice, how has the way people treat you changed since your stroke? Let's start with your family.
Baby, that just forgot me, and it's not good because they. So I was to say no, so that I won't do that. Yeah. So
they treat you like a baby?
Yeah, so I told you no. They said no, because I'm not much. I can't do, they are no more. I don't do that. Because no more. It's not that bad again.
So there's some things you can't do with your friends anymore.
Yes.
But it's not that bad.
Yeah.
Okay. And what about strangers? Do you think strangers know that you've had a stroke when they first see you?
No. They don't. But it's all right. No problem. At times they know me. They say, is that so? That's all right. It's no problem.
Pierre, stroke. Camden.
Pierre, has the way people treat you changed since you've had your stroke? For instance, your family?
Child, mum, changing.
So,
child.
Your mum treats you like a child.
Yeah.
Okay. And what about your friends? Do you think your friends find it difficult?
Yeah.
Okay. And what about strangers? Do you think strangers know that you've had a stroke when they see you?
Me asked stroke
Aha. Perfect. So that says when you get on the bus,
yes.
You show your card,
yes.
Which says, I have aphasia.
Yeah.
Please wait until I have sat down.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's right. So
yeah.
You're letting people know.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Okay.
Pierre, what are some of the changes you've had to make since living with stroke on an everyday basis?
Stroke, wheelchair, five years
yeah. Since you've been using the wheelchair. Right, so you still use the wheelchair?
Train.
You use the train,
yeah.
But you don't use the wheelchair anymore, you use the stick more, is
yes.
That right?
Yes.
Okay.
Busy. Stroke, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, opera, me, fool, yeah.
So every day of the week you are doing something different.
Yeah.
So your week is very full.
Yeah.
Hello, my name is Rita, and I live in Putney on the edge of the common. And I had my very first stroke when I was asleep in about 2003. Of all the things that I would really appreciate when I'm trying to communicate is patience. That's to me the most important thing. One of the most strangest things I feel that happened when I had my first stroke was that not only did I not realize I'd had one because it was in my sleep, but neither did my family. And it was only until I went to the optician because I was having terrible difficulty in seeing when I discovered that the stroke had destroyed the central vision of my eye.
And since having your stroke, have your family treated you differently?
No, they don't. I've got a wonderful family, and they don't fuss me, which I really appreciate. And they also are quite intolerant, actually, if they feel that I'm being a bit inept in anything I do. But I don't mind that at all.
And what about your friends? Do they treat you differently?
Oh, horribly, actually, in a nice way. They're too kind. They're too encouraging, and are very, always, I mean, I feel as if I'm an invalid, which I'm not. I'm highly independent. And after the third stroke, I tripped over and I lost the total vision out of my left eye because the optic nerve was destroyed.
And what about strangers?
Oh, they're wonderful. Strangers are always wanting to help me across the road. They take me for coffee and we discuss politics and whatever. And I just love the strangers because I can't see them. They all look beautiful because I can't see them. And it's just lovely. I actually enjoy strangers enormously. The effect of having the strokes my life has actually has changed, that's for sure. I have to go to listen to things instead of reading things or watching a film. But in the home, it's quite handy because I can't cut anything because I cut my fingers, I can't see. And so my meals are cooked for me by the family. I don't do anything of the normal things that one would do as a member of a family insofar as cooking. I have to do the washing up to show I'm independent. I do the hoovering and probably miss most things. But apart from that, it's more exciting. I actually find it extremely exciting because nothing is the same. It's like starting a life, a different life. And I quite enjoy that, actually. I like the challenge.
My name's Sandy. I live in the borough of Lambeth. I had my first stroke in August 2017 and another second stroke in October 2017. I have aphasia and dysphasia, which is usually as a result of strokes.
Sandy, what's one thing you would like people to know about living with a stroke when they're communicating with you?
Just taking a bit of time. Because you've had a stroke and you may say things a little bit slower, you are fully compos mentis.
And how has the way people treat you changed since you've had your stroke? For instance, your family?
In some ways, the roles are reversed, and I become the child, and they're more in charge. But in other ways, they haven't treated me any differently. They expect me to be able to do things that I did before, which is actually quite good for me, because otherwise I'd have a tendency to sit back and do very little, whereas they won't allow me to do that. They will make me, come on mother, get up and do that.
And what about your friends?
I think my friends are a little bit cautious. I think they're worried that because I've had two strokes, there might be another, and it might happen when I'm with them. So I feel things can be a bit tentative with them.
And what about strangers?
Most strangers don't know I've had a stroke because I've been fortunate enough that there aren't many visible signs that I've had a stroke.
What are some of the changes you've had to make since living with a stroke? You know, everyday things, like even boiling a kettle.
Again, I've been quite fortunate. I don't have the strength in my right side that I used to have. So I have to think about that before I pick up a kettle or pick up something, because I don't have the dexterity that I used to have in that side. But really, not a great deal. I just have to allow myself extra time to think.
Hi, my name is Sam. I live in Lewisham. My stroke happened on May 2014.
Sam, what's one thing you would like people to know about living with a stroke when they're communicating with you?
I beg for patience. Yeah, because my
my speech and my memory. So I have to ask a question twice or three times, and then I know the answer, but my speech. So patience is important.
And Sam, how has the way people treat you changed since you've had your stroke? We'll start with your family.
My family understand my situation, so they treated me well with cooking or bathing or anything. My family, perfect.
Great. Yes. And what about your friends? Do they treat you differently?
Since my stroke, no. Like my friends will come like once in a year or 2 years. So to me, it's fine because my friends have like things to do, like my friends have a family to take care, and I'm fine. As long as I have life, that's more important than anything.
So you don't mind that you see your friends less?
Well, if my friends either come or meet every month or two months or three, fine. If my friends say okay, once in a year, fine. As long as I'm alive, to me, that's more important than friends.
Sam, do you find other ways to communicate with your friends?
True. Text. Yeah, because with phones, with text, I have to read over and over, and then understand, and then reply, and then reply. My friends understand my situation. Like in my mind, the text is fine, but if I send, no, it's not fine, but it's to me, oh, fine.
You're doing your best, yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. And what about strangers? When people meet you, do you think they know that you've had a stroke?
No. So I have this badge.
Stroke and aphasia.
Yeah, but some people say, oh, sorry. Some people, oh, they can't care. So, yeah, like especially in the bus or tube. Yeah, but fine.
It's interesting that if you meet someone and you point to your badge, that they'd say sorry. Mm-hmm. What are they sorry for, I suppose?
Well, what? I don't know.
But you still just go along your way, really, yeah. No matter what.
Yeah, because I go out like alone in like supermarket, or because it's the noise and then and busy and no assistance. Yeah, so if I want something, I'll do online, then they will bring. Yeah,
it's interesting because I suppose it's convenient to order online.
Yes,
but it doesn't give you that opportunity to communicate.
Yeah.
Okay, that's great, Sam. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.